Welcome to Counterarts. In this lesson, we're going to be looking at the Purchases Journal. We're going to explain what it is, look at the format for the Purchases Journal, and go through some examples in completing the Purchases Journal. So what is this journal all about? Well, this is a journal used to record goods, which can be described as merchandise, stock, or inventory. So these are the goods that you sell in your ordinary course of business that are purchased on credit or on account by the entity during the period. So it's very important that it's for the goods that the company sells in its ordinary course of business, and it's what we've purchased on credit. So not what we've purchased on cash or what we've sold. So this is when we have purchased goods, which are merchandise, stock, or inventory, and we've purchased them on credit. So it can say on credit or on account by the entity during the period. It's important to note that the goods bought on cash or sold are not recorded in the purchases journal. So if you bought goods on cash, you would record that in the cash payments journal. And if you sold goods on cash or on credit, you would not record those in the purchases journal. So I hope that has made sense right away. We have done other journals as well, such as the cash payments journal, cash receipts journal, sales journals, and many other journals. You'll find them in the links in the description below. So let's look at the format for the purchases journal. Well, here it is. We start with the name of the company or the name of the entity for which we are creating the journal. And here we have an example, Eldo's Flowers. That's the name of the entity. And then we write the name of the journal. That's very important. You have to mention what journal you are preparing. And here we've written purchases journal. And very important as well, the period for which you are preparing the purchases journal. In this example, we have December 2021. So you write the name of the company, the name of the journal, and the period for which you are preparing the purchases journal. And then you can see here we have different columns. The first one here is the document number. Sometimes it's written as invoice number. This is where you put the invoice number for each particular transaction for goods that you have bought on credit. So if you bought goods on credit on a particular day and they give you the invoice or the document number, you'd put it here on the first column. If you're not given the document number, then you can write it in sequence as we explain in our other journals as well. You can write 01 for the first one, 02 for the second one, and so on. But if you are given the document number, you'd put it there. And then you have the day here. Obviously, this is the day of the month that the transaction took place. And then here you have creditor, sometimes written as details. This is the name of the creditor who sold the goods to you on credit, and you'd put down their name over there. And then here we have folio. This is a cross-reference code, and it is usually a number or a combination of numbers and letters, and it is mainly for connecting two different records. So this is showing you where else it is found in another record, or where it's taken to, or where it's coming from. But we'll leave this one out for now. And then the next column here is purchases or inventory. Now it's very important for us to note when they're using inventory and when they're using purchases. Now purchases is used when the company is using the periodic inventory system. That's very important. If they tell you that the company is using the periodic inventory system, you will write purchases under this column. But if they tell you the company is using the perpetual inventory system, then you will write inventory under this column. So if you see an example of a purchases journal and then you see this column written purchases, that means the company is using the periodic inventory system. If you see there it's written inventory, then that means that it's using the perpetual inventory system. And I hope you now know what you need to do. If you're told that the company for which you are preparing the purchases journal is using the perpetual inventory system, then you'll write inventory on this column as I've just mentioned. And if it's using the periodic inventory system, you'll write purchases. I hope that has made sense. And then the last column you have here is creditors control. This is where you put the actual amount that you owe the person who sold goods to you on credit, or the creditor himself. This is where you put that amount. So we have the purchases where you put the amount for the inventory, and you have the creditors control column where you put the amount for the creditor that you owe. Now, let's go through an example of completing a purchases journal, and it will make everything that we've been explaining clearer. Here is an example. We are told that the information given below was extracted from the records of Eldo's Flowers. Ignore VAT. Record them in the purchases journal for December 2021. The company uses a periodic inventory system. Here we go. We are told what system they're using, so we know what to put in the column that we mentioned earlier on. We're going to put purchases and not inventory because it's a periodic inventory system. If yours says perpetual inventory system, then you will put inventory on that column. So we are told also that we should ignore VAT. We've done another lesson specifically where we take VAT into account, and we went through the exact same example, but we took VAT into account. You'll find it in the link in the description below. So let's begin. On the first, Benny B, the owner, invested 30,000 rand in the business, issued receipt 010. Well, does this go into the purchases journal? Well, I hope you know the answer is no, because the owner is investing in the business. Obviously, that's capital that will go into the cash receipts journal, which we have done. You'll find it in the link in the description below. So it does not go into the purchases journal. So we're going to leave that one out. Now I'm going to highlight in purple what we are leaving out. And then what we are going to do after we have completed it, I'm going to highlight it in black. So since we are not doing the first one, because it does not go into the purchases journal, let's highlight it in purple. And then on the third, we are told that you bought goods from Ego Capital by check 2,500 rand, check 02. Does this go into the purchases journal? No, it doesn't, because we're buying goods by check, meaning we paid cash for these goods. We're not buying on account or on credit. So let's highlight it in purple as well. And then on the sixth, we bought merchandise from Zilla God on account 10,000 rand. Does this go into the purchases journal? Yes, it does, because we're buying merchandise on account or on credit. So we'll have to put it in the purchases journal. And you can see here, they might use merchandise or goods or inventory or stock. So I hope you know the wording that they may use for goods that are sold in the ordinary course of business. So let's go ahead and put this one down. We're not given the document number, so we'll just call it 01. And the day, as you can see here in red, these are the days of the month. So we have 06. So we're going to put the document number as 01 and day 06. So let's go ahead and do that. Here you can see we have put the name of the company, Eldos Flowers. We've put the name of the journal, Purchases Journal, and we've put the period for which we're preparing the Purchases Journal, December 2021. So let's go ahead. Document, like we said, we'll put 01, and obviously the transaction occurred on day 06, so we'll put that as the day. And what is the name of the creditor or the detail here? Well, let's go back. You can see we bought from Zilla God, so we're going to put the name of the creditor as Zilla God, and the amount is 10,000 rand. So let's go ahead. We've just put Zilla God as the name of the creditor. And then, like I said, we're leaving the folio out for now. And then you can see here the purchases column is because we're told that the company uses the periodic inventory system. If it was using the perpetual inventory system, then we'd put inventory here. I hope that has now been made clear. And what is the amount? Like we said, it's 10,000 rand as per the transaction. And then we go to the creditors control column. We put 10,000 rand, as that is the amount that we owe our creditor. If you check out the example that we have done on the purchases journal, where we have to take VAT into account, you will realize that the purchases column is different from the creditors control column, because purchases is excluding VAT while creditors control is including VAT. You'll check that one out after checking this one out, and it will make much more sense. Now that we have completed the first one, let's go back and highlight it in black because it goes into the purchases journal. So you can use a pen to tick or a highlighter. The reason I like doing that is so that I know I have taken everything into account and I've not left something out by mistake. On the 9th, we sold inventory on credit to Jim James 500 rand. Well, this one does not go into the purchases journal because we're selling inventory. We're not buying inventory on credit, or we're selling goods. So if we sold goods on credit or inventory on credit, we put it in the sales journal. We've done a lesson on that one as well. You'll find it in the link in the description below. So since it does not go into the purchases journal, let's highlight it in purple. And then on the 10th, we bought goods on credit from Ego Capital, 3,000 rand. So obviously this one goes into the purchases journal because we're buying goods on credit. So again, we're not given the document number, so we'll just follow the sequence. We'll put 02 and the day is day 10. So let's go ahead and do that. Document number 02 and it's day 10. And what is the name of the supplier or the creditor? Well, it's Ego Capital, as you can see. So we'll go ahead and put Ego Capital and put the amount of 3,000 rand for which we bought the goods. And under creditors control column, we put 3,000 rand as well. So you can see that the purchases column and the creditors control column is the same because we are ignoring VAT. So let's go back and highlight that one in black because it goes into our purchases journal. On the 14th, Inventory was sold for cash as per receipt 012, 12,000 Rand. Obviously, this one does not go into the purchases journal, so we'll highlight this one in purple because we're not buying inventory or goods on credit. And then on the 18th, we received goods together with credit invoice from Villa Core 4,500 Rand. Now here we received goods together with the credit invoice. Now the fact that they told us that we received the goods with the credit invoice means that we bought these goods on credit, so we have to record it in the purchases journal. So again, the document number we're not given, so we'll just follow the sequence 03, and the day is day 18. So let's go there and put document number 03 and day 18. And what is the name of the creditor? Well, you can see here it's written Villa Core. So let's go ahead and do that, Villa Core. And the amount for which we bought the goods is 4,500. And we put that under the purchases column and the creditors control column, 4,500 Rand. And then we go back and highlight that one in black because it goes into the purchases journal. And then on the 23rd, we bought equipment from Chilltree by check, 7,000 Rand. This one does not go into the purchases journal because we're not buying goods on credit and it's equipment. So these are not goods that we are reselling. So it does not go into the purchases journal for those reasons. So we're going to highlight that one in purple. And then on the 30th, we bought trading stock from Kong King as per credit invoice 04, 2,600 Rand. So here we bought trading stock and we bought it on credit, so it does go into the purchases journal. It's day 30, and here we're given the invoice number, which is 04. So if we're given the document number or the invoice number, that one we will put in the document number column. So we put 04 and we put day 30. So 04 and day 30. And what is the name of the creditor? Well, if you go back, you can see it's written Kong King. So we'll go and put Kong King there. And the purchases column, we put the amount for which we bought the goods, 2,600. And the creditors control column, we also put the same amount of 2,600 that we owe the creditor. So let's go back and highlight that one as you have just completed it. And you can see we have gone through every line item and taken them into account. So we have just completed our purchases journal. All we need to do is just to total up our columns. So we go back to our purchases journal and we total up our purchases column and our creditors control column. And obviously the totals should be the same because the amounts are the same for each transaction. And it gives us an amount of 20,100 Rand for the purchases column and the creditors control column. That is how you do the purchases journal. I hope it has made sense. I hope you've gained value from this lesson. We also provide one-on-one lessons at reasonable rates. And if you'd like to find out more or request for lessons, you can visit our website in the link in the description below or email us on the email address in the description below. Consider subscribing to our channel, like this video, and share it to those who think it might help. Till next time, cheers.